Hi, Aries. The Knight of Cups comes through at the center of the reading, first card out. I hope this finds you all making the most of Aquarius season 2020 and February 2020 in general. Two of Pentacles here as well. Two of Earth, crossing that Knight of Water. Four of Wands, Four of Fire, crowning your reading. So Aries, I did truly miss doing a reading for you all in January 2020. So I did a pick a card for the collective instead. You may want to check that out, especially if you're finding this in the last couple of days of January. I'm not exactly sure when this will be uploaded, but that's when I'm recording. So there is that as well. So no signs, got a specific January 2020 reading from Lunatics Tarot, but I'm excited to be back to them. I miss doing it. You have the Nine of Chalices here as well, Aries. A wish coming true, allowing yourself to have what you want. This is a piece of advice for you. Making a wish coming true by allowing yourself to have what you want. In your recent past, well, just in the past position, because I'm doing like an abbreviated Celtic cross for us, Aries. We've got a Piscean energy. We've got Page of Chalices, Page of Water in the reverse. Dreamy energy, a timid energy. Sometimes a stalkerish energy. Kind of actually looks like somebody held back way too long with an emotional expression. And then and now is presently, maybe it's you, Aries, overflowing with it, overwhelming. Overwhelmed with this emotion that was held back too long. Maybe it is a dream. Maybe, you know, it's an emotional expression in terms of a creative expression. Maybe that at present, Aries, you find you have an opportunity to make some type of emotional and or creative expression. But it looks like that's what the reading is all about here. This earthly opportunity coming in this month, offered to you by the divine, an opportunity for security if you decide to take advantage of this, to water this seed that all aces are, this gift, this offer. I do see that you need to make that decision though, while you have the chance, and allow the precise and impartial truth to aid you in making that decision, not any sort of defensive inclinations of yours, Aries. Instead, rather stand for what you believe in, what you believe is right for you. I'm sorry if this music's gotten too loud. It's sort of rises and falls. It looks, I also see here there's going to be a need to contemplate and meditate in complete solitude. Solemn contemplation and meditation is going to be needed in order to make that decision. And of course, it's also about this card here that's in your future position, the World card. The only major arcana card on the table. Completion, celebration, completing a major life cycle, usually, when the World card is upright. A need to celebrate the end of a chapter, a cycle in your life. Deserving to and needing to. Closing that chapter in a celebratory way, sense. After having ignored some wish, dream, love, emotion, message for too long, and then finally overflowing with it, and it does look like maybe in an imbalanced way or toward someone who's in an imbalanced state. There's this energy of not stalling any longer, but also, being unable to juggle or manage all that is on one's plate. Someone being distracted, perhaps. And so if you cannot receive, accept, or totally appreciate an emotional expression from someone, or vice versa, you find yourself making emotional expression towards someone or maybe an audience, people, multiple people in general, who can't receive the expression, the emotion that you are offering, that you really are, as I said, overflowing with at this point because you've held it back for a time. Then I do think it's because someone's stalling or distracted, imbalanced, very focused on their money, their funds, perhaps. And in this case, this is a message of you focusing on your own security, deciding to take advantage of an opportunity for yourself, not for what it offers someone else, but. For deciding not to ignore that those dreams, those emotions here from the past that maybe have been suppressed any longer, and in doing so in the name of making your own dreams and wishes come true. So it's like this emotional offering is then essentially for you, even if it is not received in the way that, you know, you may have hoped or one may hope. This is really more about you acknowledging the need to express, to make this emotional offer of love, or to create this artistic expression, if that's what it is, you know, it's still an emotional offering of love, right? When your ego is quiet, Aries, there is a happy, comfortable home and or family life, maybe specifically partnership here for you to acknowledge. Either one that you have that is vital to your situation, that is clutch in the progress, the process that you're moving through now, or one that you truly want, that you need to be honest with yourself about, one that you are aiming for, hoping for. If that is your one of your dreams, your desires, right? And yet you are making an emotional offer towards someone who is involved with more than one person or is very distracted with their money, their job, just having too many people or projects, too many things on their plate in general at this time in their life. They're too distracted, or they seem to be stalling in responding or receiving you for some reason. Then there's the message here to give yourself the secure, happy, comfortable home that you want, and maybe even the partnership as well, by refocusing on someone who is open to what it is that you're expressing. And I may be giving you the same message, even if we're talking about making an emotional expression in terms of like a creating something artistic. Perhaps you're just offering your product or your expression, your work, to the wrong audience. You know, if there's a certain demographic or, you know, certain age group or type of person, certain area of people who maybe location-wise in the world, or in a certain digital community online, something like that, who aren't receiving your work well, perhaps rather than adjusting the work, you need to adjust, you know, who you are projecting your work toward, who you are offering it toward. I think that when your ego is quiet, you know that this happy, peaceful, comfortable home and or family life is something that you are willing to fight for. And whether that's something that you're moving toward or ready to defend because you already have it, it's a humbling experience. Learning how much that means to you, how much that is worth to you. For some of you, how much you feel like it defines you, how much of what you desire and what you want is encompassed within that, a comfortable, peaceful, happy home and or family life. And how much you are willing to sacrifice, to change in order to maintain or finally achieve it, right? It's so much of what you're working for and what you're working towards, Aries, and there are necessary cuts that will have to happen. And I'm sure many of you have already been through that experience in your life. There are necessary cuts here. There's a certain individuals, parts of yourself will have to be let go of in order to achieve that. And I think that you see that clearly, and you're ready and willing to move forward. That's probably a lot of why we see an emphasis, a highlighting of the fact that taking advantage of this earthly opportunity that's presented itself to you for greater health and wealth is a decision that you have to make. It's probably because of needing to cut someone or something out, someone who's not receiving, a person or audience who's not receiving your emotional expression in the way that you would want, or some part of you that needs to be released and let go of, or, you know, both. Absolutely can be both here, with the Six of Wands and this Two of Pentacles reversed here. But again, this is your advice card to allow yourself to have what you want make your own dreams come true here rather than looking to someone else for that, expecting someone else to do that, asking for that from someone else, allowing that achievement to depend on someone else. We do see, I want to remind you, celebration, completion, a leveling up, a graduation, completion of a major life cycle, a chapter closing here in the near future for the better, for the best, one that deserves to be celebrated. And I will say finally that with both of these two showing up for us Aries, 22 may hold an additional message for you, and or just may have some sort of particular specific significance to you around this time, this month, February 2020. So Aries, we could just dig and dig deeper and deeper into this, but I think I will leave your message there for February 2020. I again truly enjoyed getting back to the individual readings for each of the signs. Thank you so much, as always, for all of your support to Lunar Ticks Tarot. It's truly appreciated, and I do hope that at least some of the needed insight was able to reach you here. If you are interested in ordering a personal reading, just scroll down to the description box below. You can find information on personal readings there, as well as donations to the channel and the decks that we use on this channel. So all of that's below. And I love you, Aries, and I look forward to doing another reading for you as soon as I can.